Having an insight into your documents in SharePoint is nice, but what's even cooler is that any documents generated via PDF Builder automatically get saved into that folder in SharePoint. We can do that via our PDF Builder Lightning component by creating an actionable, but even easier is to do that directly from our Lightning component of Collaboration Builder. Okay, let's see how we do that. First step is we need a .config. So here I have my .config to generate a quote. And I have a pack because maybe I want to send out my quote to my primary contact. Okay, how to create this .config and this pack is of course explained in PDF Builder. Now let's just use them to set up our Collaboration Builder. Okay, I go to Edit Page. I select my Collaboration Builder component. Now I copy the ID of the .config and I place it here. As you can see, you can have multiple .config IDs. You just need to separate them with a comma. In this case, I only want one. Now I can set up pack IDs. This means that I can take actions on the documents that are in my SharePoint. For instance, I want to send out a quote to my primary contact. Then I can just select that quote from Collaboration Builder and send it out. So I'm gonna paste my pack here. That's my pack ID. Same here if you want to have multiple actions, like I wanna send out for digital signature, for email, whatever, then you can just create multiple packs here and split them via a comma. My locale field, well, in this case, I just wanna use my default locale. So I'm in I'm in Belgium, so, and I speak Dutch, so it's my default locale. If you put this accent in front of it, it's hard-coded. If you remove the accent and you put in the API name of a field that's on the page layout, then that it will use that actual field on the page layout. Now it's currently hard-coded, but as you know from any Lightning component in PDF Builder, you can select the locale and the alternative. If you say, okay, some profiles cannot generate .docx, cannot generate XLS, or cannot generate PDF files, no worries, all of that can be managed directly from here. In this case, I just want to indicate that everybody can generate the document that I want to generate. Okay, let me save this. My changes are saved. Now, if I go back to my page, I would see the in Collaboration Builder, I would immediately see the quote that I'm able, or the .config that I'm able to generate. In this case, the quote. If I click the PDF button, it will generate a PDF and add that immediately in my SharePoint. If I click the doc button, then it will actually create a .docx file and put that in my SharePoint, and from here, I can immediately go and start editing that that file. As you can see, it's a very easy, simple file in this case. It has almost no data because my opportunity is empty, but it was generated in real time, and now I can just store it and make changes into this one as I please. So if I put this in yellow and I put hi demo here, so it's now saved. So if I now if I close this this item here, this document, and I refresh my page, and I take a look at the preview in Collaboration Builder, then my preview would indicate my changes. So it says hi demo, and it says thank you for it. This was put in yellow. So all of those stuff are now there. Now, next step is I have my documents now generated. Maybe teams in the background have started editing these documents. The legal team has put in their information. The engineering team put in their information. Now I want to send out this Word document to my primary contact, in this case, Jack Rogers. So the cool thing is if you select this one, you are able to mail this and it will automatically convert the docx into a PDF, so when you send it out, it will actually send out a PDF instead of a document. You don't have to go through that step manually anymore. So I just selected my DocX here, and now if I click the button Mail Quote, it will first convert it into a PDF, attach that PDF to an email message, and send it out to a recipient. This is how easy it is to send out or to generate documents directly from the Collaboration Butler component, store them in SharePoint, and start editing them from SharePoint, taking actions via PDF Butler packs.